You know, different types of materials are used to build a house. For example, mud, sand, lime, kadapa stone or granite, etc. Actually, most of these materials are minerals. And daily, we use many objects made of metals like iron, copper, lead, chrome, aluminum, etc. And these are all extracted from natural ores, which are also minerals. And there are energy minerals also, like coal, petroleum, natural gas. Even groundwater is also a mineral. So, almost anything which we get naturally from under the earth is a mineral. There are two types of resources: renewable resources and non-renewable resources. Renewable resources like wood. After cutting a tree, we can plant some other trees, and after some time we get again the wood. So they will be regenerated. And the non-renewable resources, they cannot be regenerated, like the gold, coal, petroleum, etc. If we use them continuously, they will not be available in the future. On the basis of composition, minerals are classified as metallic and non-metallic. Metallic minerals like iron ore, nickel, cobalt, copper, lead, tin, etc. Non-metallic minerals like mica, potash, limestone, sandstone, marble, etc. Mineral resources of Telangana. Telangana is a rich and variety of minerals. Telangana state is a house of various minerals. Especially, it has coal, iron ore, limestone, dolomite, manganese, quartz, feldspar, clays, barytes, uranium, black color granite, marble, etc. We find scattered medium grade iron ore in Bayyaram Reserve Forest, float iron from Mahabubad district, low grade scattered iron ore in Peddapelli and Manjarial districts. Limestone is used by cement industries in Nalgonda, Vikarabad, Peddapelli and Manjarial districts. Karimnagar district is famous for tan brown granite deposits. It is a unique granite exported on large scale to other countries like China and Southeast Asian countries. We know Shahbal stone. It is also called as the Tandoor blue limestone. It is available in Vikarabad district. We also find uranium deposits in Nalgonda district. In the villages like Lambapur, Pulicherla, Nammapuram, this coal is extracted by the Telangana Colliery's vast deposits of coal. It is a public sector unit. It is the only state in the entire southern India. Mining the minerals. Minerals are extracted by the process of mining or digging the earth. There are many ways of mining. One is open cast mining. In this open cast mining, we dig a large pit and we extract the minerals. We can blast and remove granites and barytes, etc. in this process. Second one is underground mining. In this underground mining, we built underground tunnels to mine or dig the minerals, and they are very deep. We can get crude oil or natural gas by drilling, like Bombay High near Mumbai. These mining processes disturbing the surface area by cutting down trees, destroying fields, vacating habitations, and also they are creating large pits or mounds, and they need lot of water to clean the minerals. Due to this, many rivers and water resources are polluted. On the other hand, there are many advantages of this mining. Mining is providing employment for large number of people, and by these people, many new townships are formed. About 10 lakh people in India and 1 lakh people in Telangana are provided employment by this mining. And this mining is very hazardous. The workers are exposed to many agents. Sometimes they inhale poisonous gases. This causes long-term health damage. To whom do the minerals belong? These minerals are not belong to any person. These are belong to all the people of the country. So the government consider these mines, these minerals, for the welfare of the people. At the time of independence, most of the mines were under the control of private persons. They are interested only in getting the profits and not worked for the welfare of the workers. In 1970s, the government took over all the mines and it was able to control the extent of mining. But there is no over-exploitation. The important minerals like fuels, pieces, metals were mined for the public benefit. But the government was not able to bring new technology in mining, and it is unable to survey and find out new minerals. So the government announced new policy. It is a new national mineral policy in 1993. By this, the government allowed private companies to lease mines and to operate them. With the help of that new policy, number of mines were increased and they extracted many minerals. The companies were to pay a royalty to the government. The government retained the control over mining and it continued control mining over the atomic energy also. On the other hand, the excess mining was started. Due to that, these companies extracted excess minerals than their permits without paying royalty to the government. They did not take care about the environmental protection, and also the new companies do not want to underground mining. They prefer open cast mining, which is much cheaper than the underground mining.